Hi, Mike McGuire. Welcome to Mike on a Monday, episode number 6. Believe it or not, before I was a radio host or a mediocre internet host, this is what I wanted to do for a living.
Ah!
Ooh, jeez. Are you all right? Yeah, he's fine. He'll be okay. Wrestling schools like this are where most WWE superstars start their career. Today we're going to introduce you to a gentleman by the name of Montel Vontavious Porter, MVP. And if this looks rough, you have no idea what his life was like before he even stepped into a wrestling ring. Check it out.
From Miami, Florida, weighing in at 248 pounds, Montel Vontavious Porter, MVP.
I grew up in Miami, and my mom used to take me to the Miami Beach Convention Center to see Florida Championship Wrestling, and I remember seeing Dusty Rhodes and Terry Funk and, you know, just some of those legends. And so I was always a casual fan, and by the time I was a teenager, you know, I wasn't watching very much wrestling. By that time, I was on the streets, and I was in the gangs and guns and crime, and got pretty serious pretty quick. By the time I was 15, I was locked up in a level 5 juvenile program for armed robbery, among other things. Did about 6.5 months and tried to get myself back on track, but then one of my best friends was killed by a rival gang. And I just, you know, at that age, I just stopped caring and I went back to doing the things I was doing. And I ended up committing another armed robbery. And that time around, I was adjudicated as an adult, and at 16 I received an 18 and a half year prison sentence.
Since we are talking about the world of WWE, I think it's very important that we say that this isn't part of his character, this isn't part of the gimmick that was designed for MVP. He would spend 9.5 years of that 18 and a half year sentence in prison. Now, since being a WWE superstar isn't something they really teach you how to be in prison, the question had to be asked, how did he go from that world into that of sports entertainment?
While I was in prison, towards the end of my sentence at work release, which is where you live at the facility, but you go out into society and get a job so you can reacclimate yourself to society, I met a correctional officer who went by the professional name of Primetime Daryl D. And he would bring in videotapes of indie matches, and he'd bring in titles. And I used to ask him questions all the time. And ultimately, he said, listen, I'm going to start up my own indie promotion, and you know, if you want to learn, you know, I'll teach you. And, you know, I'm just getting out of prison. I could use a hobby, something to keep me out of trouble. And he had a ring set up in his backyard, and I started training with him.
Now, aspiring pro wrestlers like this often dream of being in WWE. As MVP tells us, though, it wasn't always the dream so much as he believes as it was fate.
You know, I think it was destiny, and it's weird because when I was a kid, the first time I got in trouble, I was in the juvenile detention center. And they had like a career day, and one of the staff members was a wrestler by the name of Death Row, and he brought in a guy by the name of Soul Man Alex G. Then fast forward to me being in work release with Primetime Daryl D, and he brought in a videotape of an indie show, and there's Soul Man Alex G. I'm like, hey man, I know that guy. I met him a long time ago. So come full circle, here I am with this guy I met, you know, 11 years before, who essentially trained me to wrestle. So I think it was fate, destiny.
Going back to where you were growing up in the gangs, in trouble, to where you are now, I mean, literally, you are a worldwide superstar. I mean, you're on video games, action figures, you're in people's homes every week. Could you imagine back then being where you are now?
You know, it's funny, because I always used to fantasize about being famous, you know, because interestingly enough, here's a good opportunity for me to bring up that I recorded a new theme song, because, you know, a lot of people don't know this about me, but I can rap.
From Miami, Florida, weighing in at 259 pounds, Montel Vontavious Porter, MVP.
And some new music for MVP. I like it.
You want to get the party started? Call Mr. 305M.
So I had dreams of being a famous rapper. You know, nothing ever came of it. And I never in the world dreamed that I'd be a WWE superstar. And now there are times when I have to stop and just look around at my reality because, you know, single mom, 3 kids, you know, there were times when things were really, really tight, you know, and we never really had much. We had enough, but we didn't have much. And, you know, now when I you know, walk in my spacious home, and I get in my Mercedes, and I, you know, have experienced this superstar lifestyle. And it's breathtaking sometimes, and I have to stop and reflect and just appreciate my circumstances.
As MVP reflected on his life and the changes that have occurred over the past few years, he says it's important not to forget where he came from. MVP now uses his platform as a celebrity and WWE superstar to reach out to inmates and other at-risk youth to show that they can, in fact, rise above their surroundings, much like he did.
Being able to stand up and say, you know, yeah, I'm an ex-convict, but now I'm a WWE superstar. And where once upon a time people saw me crossing the street and would reach over and try to lock their door discreetly, now those people want to run up and embrace me. So it's vindication, it's redemption.
I think the coolest part of your story is that now, being in the position you're in, you take the time to give back and actually kind of give that inspiration. What I want to do, and I want to close this on, is maybe you just kind of talking to the folks that are watching this right now who may have either been in your spot or know someone who has been, and I'm just going to hand you this and let you go ahead.
Well, as a WWE superstar, I feel almost that it's my responsibility to reach out to underprivileged youth, ex-convicts, you know, people who feel that they're behind the eight ball, because I grew up with next to nothing, and I decided that I was going to take a shortcut, and, you know, I was going to become a criminal and get what I wanted the easy way. And they say that crime doesn't pay. That's not true. Crime pays, and it pays well. But what you don't know is that you got to pay it all back with interest, one way or the other. Whoever you are, if you know someone that's, you know, it's you know, running the streets or not living that upstanding life, if you are that person, or if you feel that the world's against you, I've been there. I know exactly what you're feeling. You have to figure out what it is you want to do in life. Figure out what it is that makes you happy and do it. Don't let anybody tell you what you can't do. Believe in yourself. And it's going to take sacrifice. It's going to take deferred gratification. But if you believe in yourself, you can make it happen. And I did it. And I'm not saying that it's going to be easy. It's going to be hard. There were times when I said, man, I'll never make it. I'm going to quit. But the same dedication that I had to doing wrong, I had to put that into doing right. And there were people that laughed at me and said, WrestleMania, WWE superstar, never happened. And a friend of mine gave me this quote. When you tell people what your dreams are, if they don't laugh at you, then you're not dreaming big enough. Believe in yourself and don't let anybody tell you what you cannot do.
MVP, thank you so much for the time and appreciate
it. Absolute pleasure, man.
Absolutely. Now with a pinfall, the world-class athlete extraordinaire, the cornrow-wearing, savoir-faring, jaw-dropping, bottle-popping, modern-day Mac has done it again. I put my time on the line. He didn't put his time on the line. I'm just saying.
Let the record know.
You got a feeling it took easy. We'll just get past that part.
Yeah, beautiful. Yeah.
Let's come here. Jump shot.
I'll take my wrist, man.
Take the wrist? All right.
And then you got to fall away.
Fall away?
Fall away.
All right. Said fall away.
We ballin', straight up ballin'.
It feels good to be back in a ring. These wrestlers, though, they're not that tough. Really. Oh, jeez. These guys.
L-A-N-Y-M-I-A, so fly. See me out on South Beach, living life out of reach.